life. And I looked at my wife like I did something right. Look, I'm not switching my price. Baby, I know what I'm worth. I be like, thank God it's Monday. I get to get back to work. Hey, shine like gold. They don't want story, man. They want the soundbite. I'm like, no. Look around like they see you on the mountain. They don't see you on the climb. Right? Me and all of mine in the power line. Look at this and what you find. Right?
Shoot. Nice. Flick.
Welcome back to Kaylee's Weekly Bible Lessons. So I hope you are doing the best right now. I hope you're feeling amazing, confident, beautiful, and wonderful, because that's who God says you are. So as you can see, I kind of have a lot of energy right now. That's because I just finished my devotional. And man, can we first off just acknowledge how good our God is? Can we just acknowledge him right now? Because God, you are so, so good. But as you can see, so I usually have my camera set up with like the ring light and stuff. And this wall right here usually has some stuff on it. As you can see, everything's gone. As you know, we're moving and all the stuff has been taken off my walls. So we're gonna do my devotional in a different setting today. I'm not gonna tell you where, it's a surprise. But today's gonna be pretty, pretty chill. You're still gonna get a good word. I'm still gonna feed you good. You're still gonna get fed, but I'm in my workout clothes right now. I woke up at 4:40 and I went to the gym with my mom. So I'm still in my workout clothes. So before we get anything started, I just wanted to give you all a little life update. So as you all know, in my last video, I talked about how we found the potential home. And unfortunately, we did not get the home, sadly. Yeah, life happens, but we know that God has so, so much in store for our lives. And sometimes he has to take us through the valley in order for us to get to the mountain. So that's what we're trusting in God for. We know we're trusting in God for so, so much in our lives. And actually, we have found an apartment. So we're moving into an apartment, but we are praying. Y'all better just pray for us, because we are just waiting to get the confirmation email and we will be good and set to move to Kansas City. But obviously the apartment will just be permanent. I mean, temporary, but eventually we'll be moving into a home. But just keep us in your prayers. I'm staying strong. I'm staying good. I'm trusting in God, and I'm just continuously putting my faith and my trust in him. And that just shows how much I love and care for him. But I hope you all are ready to be fed. I am so, so excited to be making this video today. And also, by the way, it's like 8 a.m. Today is a super, super busy day. Our house this is literally the first day that our house is open to people to start and coming looking, because obviously we're putting our house on sale. So I have to clean up the whole house, gotta get this video uploaded. I have a doctor's appointment. So I just have a lot of stuff going on today. So I needed to make this video early this morning in order to get everything I needed done today. But I hope you all are ready to get fed. Let's get into this video. Hey, so welcome to my sunroom. So my house, well, little backstory before we get into the word. My house was built in the 1980s, well, the current house we live in. And not a lot of houses have sunrooms, I don't think, anymore. So they either, in some houses, they'll either like tear it down and build like something else on it, or they'll make it into a room. But this is our sunroom, and that's where we're gonna be. That's where I'm gonna be feeding you all today. And my dad's outside watering our grass. So let's get into today's word. I hope you all are ready. This is probably one of my favorite things to do. And to be honest, with us being so just, you know, busy and stuff like that lately, I feel like the devil's just trying to get into my mind, just trying to hinder me from doing some of the stuff that I love to do. But I'm here today, I'm happy, I'm strong, and I'm doing what I think God is calling me to do in this season of my life. So last week we left off on Romans 7 notes, and that's what we're going to be getting into today. So let's get this started. All right. My first point for today is, if we know the word and still go against it, we need help. Ooh, if we know the word and still go against it, we need help. Okay, let's think about this clearly. If you know the word, why would you go against something that's clearly trying to help you and clearly trying to make you better? Just think about that for a sec. I want you to think that in. If you know the word, why would you go against it? If you do go against it, you honestly do need help, because God's word is trying to help you. God's word is trying to uplift you, but you're trying to go against that? Why would you continuously go into your flesh? Why would you continuously go into what the world thinks about you? Why wouldn't you go and lean into what God says about you? You know God's word is truth. You know God's word is light. So why do you keep going against it even though you know it? It's either you fully don't know who you are, or you just don't care. So it's either you just don't care, or you truly don't know who you are. So I suggest you either start knowing who you are, or you just start caring, because God cares for you and God loves you. And I'm here to help. So this is why we need to get into our word. This is why we have to know who we are. Because when we don't know who we are, we stop caring. And then when we stop caring, we start sinning. And when we start sinning, we start leaning into our flesh. So we need to start getting into it. Get into your word, so you can truly know who you are, so that you don't have to be worried about what others think about you. So you don't lean into your flesh, but you lean into the word. Don't lean into your flesh, lean into the word. Don't lean into your flesh, lean into the word. Okay, so yeah, let's get into our next point. If we work for sin our whole life, our eternity is death, but God's gift is real and eternal life. Yes, that is so good. If we work for sin our whole life, our eternity is death. Eternity. Our forever is death. But if God's gift is real, our forever is life. Do you want your forever to be death? Or do you want your forever to be life? It's a matter of choosing death or life, the world or the word, flesh or the word, or death or life. So it's a matter of choosing, what do you think is the best for your life? Because the best thing about God, you want to know the best thing about God? He is not pushy, he is not shovy. You don't have to be a Christian. You don't have to get into your word. You don't have to do your devotional. You don't have to do your quiet time. It's a matter of you choosing what you want. God, he's God. He controls the whole world. But he won't force you to love him. He will always love you. He will always love you. That's why he sent his son to die for you. He wouldn't have did that if he didn't love you. But the fact is, do you want to choose God, all that he has for you, or yourself? Because God created the world, the universe. He knows everything. So would you rather choose yourself, being selfish? Would you rather choose yourself? Or would you rather choose all that God has for you? It's a matter of thinking, I'm limitless. When it's just me, I'm limitless. But with God, I have power, I have a voice, and I can have faith and trust in him to get me through situations. Example, like we're trying to move, We didn't get the house that we wanted. Yes, we wanted that house. We wanted that house. But maybe God didn't want that house for us. So it's a matter of, we can either be sad. We can either be like, man, okay, we didn't get that house. Ugh, I'm mad at God now because we didn't get that house. Or we can be like, okay, yeah, you know, I'm disappointed. We love that house, but maybe that's not what God really wanted for us. Maybe he wants to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. So it's a matter of you choosing God over just you. Life or death, the word or flesh. The moment we try to do good, all we see is the devil trying to tell us that good is wrong. That's good. The moment we try to do good, all we see is the devil trying to tell us that good is wrong. I definitely can relate with this point. When I'm trying to do this right here, what I'm trying to do here, man, I don't even think y'all understand the temptation that I get sometimes. It's like, hey Lee, I know I'm different. I know I'm alive. I know I can be alive in this world. I know I can be alive in darkness. I know this YouTube platform is how I'm getting my voice out. And my voice, it does have power. I'm utilizing it. But there's a little side note in my ear that devil coming to talk to me, talking like, hey Lee, you don't have to listen to your parents. You don't have to go wash your dishes. You don't have to go clean up. You don't have to do this. But guess what? Would I rather listen to death or life? I choose life. Because I would rather live in light than death. I'd rather live to God's desires than the world's desires. The devil? That's full-on world. That's full-on death. But God, that's full-on life. That's full-on world. That's full-on word. So you see how you say light. When you say light, it's like light. When you say death, it's like. When you think of death, yes, death, it's death. So I know sometimes when you think of death, sometimes you think of a loved one that might have passed away. Which is sad because we love our loved ones, and when they pass away, it is sad. But it can be sad. But hopefully, if your loved one does know the Lord, then they'll get to live with him in eternal life in heaven. So I'm choosing. I have a lot of life left on the in earth, but I know that I'm leaving a mark for the world. I don't want to leave the world knowing that I didn't make a difference, that I didn't try to be the light for God, that I didn't try to do everything in my power to be the young lady that God has chosen me to be. Because I know I'm chosen. I want to be a light. I'm not going to listen to what the devil says. I'm not going to listen to him because I know that God has more for me than what the devil is trying to tempt me into. So you can either lean into the temptation. You can either lean into the temptation or you can lean into the word. Lean into the temptation or lean into the word. I'm going to lean into the word, y'all, because there will be times, man. Okay, so when we were in Kansas, I woke up at 5 a.m. and my aunt and uncle at their house, they have a deck outside. And let me tell you all, I watched the sunrise and it was probably one of the best experiences of my life, which I will definitely be doing again. I don't think you all understand how beautiful God's creation is. God is so, so, so good. He made the world. He made the universe. He made the stars and the moon. He made everything. He made everything beautiful. You can either choose beauty or you can choose death. Beauty or death. I choose beauty, and I hope that you choose beauty too. This is why I feel like I'm doing my part. Because if I'm I'm a believer. If I'm me, believer, am not doing my part, how is the gospel supposed to get out? God has left us on earth. He's left us his kingdom on earth. He's left his kingdom on earth so that we can do our part for the kingdom. Because in heaven, they're rejoicing up there. They're having the time of their life. But we can't get to that unless we share the gospel, unless we get heaven filled. Because when Jesus comes back, he's taking the believers, he's taking the saved, he's taking the saints. But don't you want that for your friend? Don't you want that for your family member? Don't you want that for everyone? So if you want that for everyone, go do your part. I want to ask you a question, and I'm going to do maybe two more points and close it out. But I want to ask you a question, and I want you to listen. When was the last time you shared God's word with someone? When was the last time you had at least been a light? When was the last time you didn't cuss? When was the last time you did something and knew it was wrong, but you still did it anyway? When was the last time you did something like that? See, sometimes we have to reflect on ourselves, and I'm not perfect, y'all. No one's perfect. Jesus was the only perfect person on earth. But it's a matter of acknowledging when you do wrong. See, God rewards those who acknowledge when they do wrong. But the beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing about God is he'll still give us a consequence when we do stuff wrong. And I know you're like, why is that good? Well, it's because it shows us what we did wrong. And God will be like, okay, I still love you. But guess what? There's still a consequence. So that shows that God's still faithful. He still loves us. He's still truth. But there always will be a consequence for your actions, whether it's good or bad. So if it's a consequence for bad, let's say you do something bad, there's a bad consequence. But if say you did something good, there will be a good consequence. So it's a matter of choosing between your choice. It's a choice. Literally, it's a choice. With every decision you make in life, it's a choice. And what I've said once again, the great thing about God is he gives us a choice. So it's a matter of following the creator of the world or just me. So on Tribes Wednesday? Yeah, that was Wednesday. We talked about how we're basically just like a little speck in the whole universe, but we still have so much power, but we're still like this little tiny speck. I'm a little tiny speck, you know what I'm saying? I'm still beautiful, I'm still fearfully wonderfully made, I'm still chosen, but here's the thing, I'm still just a tiny, tiny, tiny little speck. So it's a matter of me using my voice and using my power, because I have power. I have a voice, and so do you. So do you. All the things that I feel about myself, you are the same. You are beautiful, you are chosen, and you are all that God has for you. You are all that God says you are. So I know you can doubt that sometimes. I know you can feel like I know sometimes you can reflect and be like, wow, in this big universe, I'm just small. Yes, you might be tiny in this big universe, but you still are God's masterpiece. You are a masterpiece. You are a work of art. And don't ever question who God created you to be, because God knows everything. God knows everything. So don't ever question who he says you are. And let me tell you, I want you to choose light for that. I want you to choose the word of the flesh. I want you to choose God over yourself. I'm actually just gonna do 1 point and then I'm gonna close it out. But I just want you all to know I love you all so much. And this is one of the best parts about being a believer, is getting to share God's word and hopefully help and pour into someone's life. So I'm gonna do one more point. But we have to block ourselves away from that. We have to guard our hearts and minds. This point connects to the last point, which was the moment we try to do good, always see the devil telling us that good is wrong. But then it says, but we have to block ourselves away from that. We have to guard our hearts and minds. And you guard your heart and mind through the word. So that's why you have to read the word, and that's why you have to get into the word, because the word will guard your heart and guard your mind. Whew. Okay, y'all. Man. God is so good. God is so good. And I just realized I didn't pray before I started. So, I'm gonna pray right now. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you. We just want to thank you because you are so good. You are so good. Your word is magnificent. You're beautiful. Your creation is beautiful. And because your creation is beautiful, so are we, God. And thank you that we have the opportunity to learn more about ourselves daily and more about you. I'm grateful for YouTube, God. Though YouTube is filled with things that are ungodly, but I have the opportunity to step into the ungodliness and bring it to light, to make that ungodliness godly with my channel, God. I want to spread light. I don't want to be in the darkness, God. I don't want to live to myself. I don't want to live to my flesh. Because when I live to my flesh, that leads to destruction. That leads to terror, God. Everything that is against you. But when we follow you, God, that's when we find our power. That's when we find our hope. That's when we find our grace, our mercy, love, joy, peace, all of the fruits of the Spirit, God. Everything. We find ourselves. We truly find ourselves. So help us, God, to be everything that you need us to be today. Help us to call that friend. Help us to be that light, God. Allow us to reflect on ourselves. Allow me to reflect on myself, because none of us are perfect, God. And we have to daily reflect ourselves, making sure that we are doing everything that you need us to be, and that we're being everything you need us to be, and that we are being everything that you have called us and chosen us to do. Forgive us for all of our sins, God. Cleanse and renew our hearts and our souls, God. Allow us to go into our word for our help, for our guidance, because the word is the only place where we can find that. So help us, God, to be everything that you have called us to be. Allow us to do everything in our power to make sure that you are glorified. We don't want to be glorified. You need to be glorified. Allow everything to be done by your will. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen, y'all. Amen. Well, I love you all so, so much. Make sure you like, subscribe, and turn on those post notifications so you can be notified every single time I post a new video. And share this video with your friends, y'all. Share this video with your mom, your dad, your aunt, your uncle, your grandma, your grandpa. It doesn't matter who. Share this video. It's not just for teens. It's for kids. It's for all. So I hope you all are ready for more content coming out. I love you all. Remember, you are loved. Remember to choose what you think is best for your life. Yes, I am a believer. Yes, I choose all that God has for me. But maybe you choose different things. So make sure that whatever you choose for your life is what you think is best. Everything should be what God thinks is best. But if you're not a believer, maybe you have different beliefs. But I'm just letting you know, this is what we as believers should choose. I love you all so much. I will see you all next week. Bye.
Life. And I looked at my wife like I did something right. Look, I'm not switching my price. Baby, I know what I'm worth. I be like, thank God it's Monday. I get to get back to work. Hey, shine like gold. They don't want story, man. They want the sound.